Today's video is brought to you by T-Metric. T-Metric is the simple time tracking app to help you manage every minute of your day. Are you a freelancer and need to keep track of billable hours? Well, T-Metric makes invoicing those hours to your clients so much easier. And best of all, T-Metric integrates directly with some of your favorite tools, including Google Docs, Gmail, Asana, Trello, and so much more. To try T-Metric for yourself, click the link in the description below. Have you ever been working within Google Sheets and having multiple sheets of data and wishing that you could sum them all up together in a separate sheet? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And you know, sometimes there's good reason why we have multiple sheets for different pieces of information. Maybe this represents different managers or members of your team. Maybe this represents different sales areas or sales regions, for example. So you may want to keep them separate because people are entering information just for their area, but you'd like to total them all up in a separate sheet. Now it's true, I could take the information, for example, from B and C. I could cut or copy it and bring it over here to A, but I want to show you a much better way of doing this, especially if you're going to be adding more information in the future. So here I've got a tab, a sheet called Total. And the first thing that we need to do is we want to make sure that we have our headings that are exactly the same as the other sheets that we are going to combine. So I'm just going to copy and paste that over here. Now the next step that we are going to add here is we're going to add a formula. So in the very first cell, just below date, I'm going to hit that equal sign. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a brace, or sometimes better referred to as a squiggly bracket. Not just a regular bracket, a squiggly bracket. And we're going to come over here to Team A, and we're just going to select all of the data that we want. Now we're going to hit our semicolon button on our keyboard, and we're going to go to Team B and do the exact same thing. We're going to select all of the information that we want from this sheet. We're going to hit semicolon once more, go to Team C, and once again, we're going to select all of that information as well. We're going to close things off by hitting that squiggly bracket once again at the end of our formula there, hit enter, and now here on our total sheet, we have everything from A, B, and C. If we look down here, we've got, it says we've got 30 rows. Now let's subtract one, right? Because we've got our header up here. So we really have 29 rows. So if we go back here to Team A, remember to subtract one. We've got 12 plus 6, that's 18, plus 11. Yeah, that adds up to 29. So we've got all of that information here on this particular tab. So that's great. It looks like we're finished, right? Well, maybe there's one problem. Maybe this is all you need for right now. But what if you are planning to add more information to, you know, one of these sheets over here or other members of your team? Let's say I'm here on Team B, and I'm going to add a new entry here, okay? I'm going to add, let's add myself, just so it stands out from the rest of the list here. Let's give ourselves a state. Let's say I'm selling binders, and let's say I am an absolutely horrible sales executive. All right, so I've added my new data here. Perfect, Team B. If I go over to my total area, if I scan down, and I'm not seeing any zeros here. I don't see my name here. That's a bit of a problem, right? Because I want to be able to add information over there and have it show here, but it's not happening. I've made that new entry and it's not showing up here. So let's see how we can tweak our formula up here so we can do just that. So a couple of things. At first, we're going to come in here and we're going to look at the cells that we're referencing. One of the problems is that we are saying to finish at E13. We want to finish at that row. But of course, as we're adding things, we're going to be going well beyond that. So the first thing that we want to do is come in here and actually remove the row number. We want to leave the column, of course, column E, but we want to come in here and remove the row number. So E7 becomes E, and over here, E12 just becomes E as well. But watch what happens when I hit enter and change this formula. So, what happened here? So this is Team A, right? That looks like Team A has come over. And you may be saying it didn't even bring over Team B and Team C. Well, actually, you'd be wrong. But here's the problem. I have to scroll all the way down to, I think, about the thousands, somewhere around there. And look at that. There's Team B. And if we scroll down 1,000 more, we would get to around Team C. It is grabbing all of those empty or null cells. Well, that's a problem, right? That's certainly not what we want. So let's go back in here and alter our formula once again. We're gonna leave those E's the way they are, but what we wanna do is add a query. So at the very beginning of our formula, we are gonna type in the word query and an open bracket, all right? So an open bracket here is gonna allow us to have this query. We're gonna keep everything that we left in there, everything that we left from that original formula minus the row number, and we're gonna come to the end here and hit comma. Now, we're gonna hit our quotation marks and we are going to enter in the following. We're gonna say select. This is how we're gonna make sure that we're only getting information that contains values. We're gonna say select asterisk, that's sort of our wild card, right? The star, select where column one, and that's capital C-O-L one, that's looking at column one or column A in all of those different sheets that we're referencing, select star where column one is, oops, did I put in another space, is not null. Okay, so whenever it's gonna go back and take a look, and it's only gonna bring in information where there are things where there is information in that date column. And lastly, we wanna hit our quotation marks to close that off. And one more, we're gonna do our bracket to close off the full equation. Let's hit enter and hope that this works. Okay, looks like we've got a lot more information here. Do we have all the same information we had before? We have all the same information and then some. Hey, there's me. There's my poor sales job of selling absolutely nothing. So there's that new entry we made. Now it went and grabbed that information from Team B. Let's do one more quick test just to make sure that this works. I'm gonna put in a new entry here on Team C this time. Let's say, let's call this one Jenny Sample, also from Washington, let's say. And she's selling art and she is an amazing salesperson. She sold $45,000 worth of art the other day. So if I go back to total now, hey, look what's showing up at the very bottom. So now with that new formula that we put in on this total sheet, we can continue to add new lines, new information to these sheets, and they will total up perfectly here on this final sheet. Well, I hope that you found today's video helpful, and I would love to hear from you next. What other tips would you like to learn about Google Sheets here on the Simpletivity channel? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.